हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? वेलकम इन क्लास. आई एम भूपेंद्र वर्मा, योर साइंस टीचर. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर गार्बेज इन एंड आउट ऑफ क्लास सिक्स साइंस. दिस इज आवर 17 चैप्टर इन बुक. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट वॉट इज अ गार्बेज, टाइप्स ऑफ गार्बेज एंड हाउ टू मैनेज द गार्बेज. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट दिस पार्ट. First is try to understand what is a garbage. And the first term is what is garbage. The garbage means the waste material which have no longer use to are known as garbage. That means the each household generates garbage or waste every day. We throw away the items that are no longer need. वो चीज़ें जिनका हमारे घर में ज़्यादा यूज़ नहीं है, लंबे टाइम के लिए डैमेज हो जाती हैं, दे आर कॉल्ड वेस्ट विच आर थ्रोन अवे इन टू द डस्टबिन्स आर नोन एज गार्बेज. द गार्बेज जनरेटेड बाय एन एंटायर टाउन और सिटी इज कलेक्टेड बाय द म्यूनसिपल अथॉरिटीज. हु कलेक्टेड द एंटायर टाउन गार्बेज? द एंटायर टाउन गार्बेज इज कलेक्टेड बाय म्यूनसिपल अथॉरिटीज ऑफ द सिटी. म्यूनसिपल अथॉरिटीज ऑफ द सिटी कलेक्टेड द होल garbage. Okay students, the municipal authorities who collected the garbage, the municipal authorities collect the total city garbage and manage them. Dumps and dispose. The amount of garbage is so huge that disposing it off is an immense problem because city produce a lots of amount of garbage because each people in every house release the individually much garbage and it is collected so much and huge amount is collected. That is immense problem. What is immense problem? Immense problem means a very difficult problem to manage it. It cannot be burnt as this generates smoke and poisonous gas. So first point is here, it cannot burn. Because it cannot burn, it generates lots of smoke and poisonous gases that create the air pollution. That creates the air pollution and pollute the water of city. It cannot be thrown into water as it will be pollute the water. This garbage cannot thrown into the water bodies because it can also pollute the water. इसे गार्बेज को पानी में भी नहीं डाल सकते और जला भी नहीं सकते. बिकॉज इफ इट कैन बर्न इट्स क्रिएट एयर पॉल्यूशन, इफ इट कैन थ्रोन इन टू वाटर दैन इट्स क्रिएट वाटर पॉल्यूशन. यूजली अ सिटी गार्बेज इज डिस्पोज ऑफ इन टू लो लेइंग ओपन एरिया इज कॉल्ड लैंड फिल. लो लेइंग ओपन एरिया इज कॉल्ड लैंड फिल. वॉट इज लैंड फिल? द लो पिट्स और लो लेइंग एरिया इन विच गार्बेज इज फिल्ड and after that covered with the layer of soil is known as landfill. And here is a part of the garbage that can be used again is separated out. First of all, the part of garbage that is again used is separated out. Which is again used? The garbage which is reused and recycled is known as again used. Non-useful part is spread over the landfill and covered with the layer of soil. The non-useful part are spread over the landfill and covered with the soil. After the landfill is completely full, it converted into park or a playground. For example, the Indraprastha Park in New Delhi is built on such a landfill. Okay students, I hope you understand this part. Next is types of wastes. The waste is generally two kinds. One is biodegradable waste, another is non-biodegradable waste. Let us discuss one by one each. Biodegradable waste. The waste is a waste that will decay and mix with the soil. All waste that derived from living matter is biodegradable. What is the mean of that? Biodegradable waste is that waste which decay and mix with the soil. What is the mean of decay? Decay means decompose with the help of microorganism or known as decomposer bacteria. What is the mean of decay? To break down the waste into with the help of microorganism into small particles is known as decay. And after that mix with the soil is known as biodegradable waste. For example, all waste derived from living matter. Derived means to gain. All waste derived from living matter is biodegradable. That means all waste we get from living things like plants, such as animal waste, is known as biodegradable waste. This includes food waste such as fruits, vegetable peels, etc. And meat is also a part of biodegradable waste. The plant parts like leaves, flowers, paper, pencil shavings, all are biodegradable waste, because if we buried this biodegradable waste into a pit and cover with the soil for a week, then after 1 week we observe that these things are mixed with the soil well, so that's why they are called biodegradable waste. Next is non-biodegradable waste. The waste that will not decay and mix with the soil. The waste that will not decay and mix with the soil is called non-biodegradable waste. That means that do not decompose into fine particles with the help of microorganisms is known as non-biodegradable waste. Now, for example, plastics such as bags of plastics, packing materials made by plastic metals. For example, containers of metals, cold drink cans of metals, pins of metals, needles of metals, all are non-biodegradable. And the glass items like bottles, broken glass pieces and bulbs, all things are non-biodegradable waste. For example, if we bury these things into a pit and cover with the soil in the same, then after a week, after 15 days, after a month, after a year, we observe that these things are never changed and never mixed with the soil well. So these things are known as biodegradable waste. I hope, students, you have to clear the concept of biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste. So now we manage and read the way to how to reuse and recycle the waste. How to reuse and recycle the waste. That means reuse. First of all, understand the meaning of reuse. Reuse means amount of waste thrown away to reuse whatever can be used again. Listen one thing. In an easy sense, we say, what is a reuse? The process or the procedure in which the things are used again and again. The procedure in which the things are used again and again is known as reuse. Suppose, for example, we drink a cold drink from a cold drink bottle. Then after that, we use for many purposes like storage of water, storage of milk and storage of lassi, etc. So this is a kind of reuse. This is a kind of reuse. Like utensils which we are used in our kitchens are made up of steel, pitel, etc. So these things are reused again and again. We not thrown into the dustbin. Another is a recycling. What is the mean of recycling? Recycling involves the collecting of waste material and after processing them to make a new products. Recycling means to involves collecting of waste. First of all, collecting the recycled waste materials and after processing them to make the new products. After processing them to make the new products from them is known as recycling. For example, if we sell the paper to the garbage collector and these garbage collector again send the paper to the factories, and factories first tear the paper, crush the paper well, then after that mix with the water till it's make a pulp. After making pulp, they remove the ink and gum etc. from the paper. They remove the gum, ink and etc. from the pulp of matter, then remove it well, then after that make a new paper from it. This is known as recycling of paper. Both reusing and recycling and reduce the amount of waste. Which two procedures reduce the amount of waste? Reusing and recycling reduce the amount of waste. So if we adapt these methods, then we reduce the amount of waste thrown into the community dustbins. Therefore makes the environment clear. Therefore, make the environment cleaner. How to make the environment cleaner? To reuse and recycle the waste. That is recycled or reused. Next is segregation of waste. What is the mean of segregation? Segregation means to separate. Segregation means to separate. Segregation means to separate the waste. That means there are two kinds of waste required to different method of disposal. Therefore, the first step is to segregate the waste into biodegradable and non-biodegradable. Where the biodegradable waste is thrown into which color dustbin? In green color dustbin. We throw biodegradable waste into green dustbin and non-biodegradable waste into blue color dustbin. The blue color show the non-biodegradable waste and green color represent the biodegradable waste. And there is another two color dustbin, that is yellow and black, that are used for the medical waste, that are used for the poisonous or medical waste. Every household should have the two garbage bins, one is biodegradable waste and another for non-biodegradable waste. The things which we are thrown mostly in the kitchen items are all are biodegradable, like tea leaves, vegetable peels, fruit particles, waste food, all are biodegradable waste. And the things which are the other used in our home, such as plastic, etc., are non-biodegradable waste. Ideally, this should be a third bin is toxic, that is usually black in color. The toxic for black and yellow in color for toxic waste, such as medicine, batteries, chipsets, etc. Now, next is recycling of biodegradable waste. How to recycle the biodegradable waste? Biodegradable waste can be recycled by the method of composting. Biodegradable waste by the method of composting. And let us try to understand what is a method of composting. In method of composting, first, on a layer of the soil, we cover the layer of soil with the help of biodegradable waste. Then again cover with the soil, then again biodegradable waste, then again cover with the soil, then again biodegradable waste. Now these these microorganisms this compost section have a pores in it to pass the air from it, and these are decomposed well and mixed with that soil layers and form a compost. Compost means khad, which are used in fields to provide the nutrients to the plants. It ensures that the waste is not carelessly thrown and left to decay. इसमें हमें एक चीज़ ध्यान रखनी होती है, जो वेस्ट है उसे केयरलेसली नहीं फेंकना चाहिए, ध्यान रखना चाहिए डीके करने के लिए. द मेन्योर ओबटेन्ड इज वेरी रिच इन न्यूट्रिएंट्स एंड इट इज़ एन एक्सीलेंट मीडियम फॉर ग्रोइंग प्लांट्स. देन अपार्ट फ्रॉम बींग ओके स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड वट इज़ अ कंपोस्ट. एंड नाउ दैट इज इफ यू थ्रो द केयरलेसली देन इट्स नॉट यूज फॉर रिसाइकलिंग एक्सेट्रा. देन apart from being clean, cheap and safe, composting also reduces the amount of disposable garbage. So this is a disposable garbage used to convert into compost, and compost is a very good for the plants and provide the nutrients to the plants. Next is vermicomposting. This is another method of composting where compost is made from biodegradable waste with the help of a type of earthworm called redworms. Vermicomposting is another method of composting where the compost is made from biodegradable waste with the help of a type of earthworm. That means earthworm are kind of worms that convert the soil into a fine particles or a very good compost. That is known as vermicomposting. Why it is called vermicomposting? Because it is made by the worms. And which kind of special worms? Red worms are known as vermicomposting. And what are the red worms? Kenchue are called red worms. Okay students, I hope you have to clear this part. What is compost and what is vermicompost? Next is activity to show that how to make a compost. So try this activity at home and try to prepare the compost at your home. Use this activity, you are able to prepare the compost. And the experiment 3 show that vermicomposting. So let us understand what is a show in experiment. To make a compost, collect the garbage from your house and at the end of day, divide into biodegradable and non-biodegradable. So first of all, tell me students, how to divide biodegradable, non-biodegradable? You know that well, the vegetable peels, fruits, curd, waste food, etc. are the part of biodegradable. So separate it well and divide each into two heaps. hips. What is the meaning of hips? Hips means dher. Two for biodegradable and two for non-biodegradable. And label A, B, that is biodegradable, C, D for non-biodegradable. Put one biodegradable and non-biodegradable hip into plastic bags. Now, from the one of the biodegradable put into plastic bag, and one from the non-biodegradable put into plastic bag. And one biodegradable is free now, and one non-biodegradable is free now. And hold them out tightly. Now make a 4 pits. Put 2 plastic bags and 2 heaps in the separate pits and cover with the soil, and again also repeat with the same one. Remove the soil after a week, smell of garbage and observe its color. The rotting is complete. Rotting means sudden. Sadhana, rotting. There will be no foul smell and the color will be black. Note the garbage has not cleaned at all, rotten rapidly, partially and rotted completely. The rotting is not complete. Cover the bags again and soil. Keep observing after a week and fill your observation in the table. So students, we have a totally A, B, C and D. A and B are biodegradable. C and D are non-biodegradable. So the biodegradable waste, which in a plastic bag is partially decomposed, and which is directly add with the soil, is completely decomposed. And both of the non-biodegradable are not decomposed, no change any change, and no gives the any foul smell. Even it's after 8 weeks also. I hope students, you have to clear this observation and try this activity at your home. Next is vermicomposting. Vermicomposting is made by the help of worms. If you have worms are available in your surrounding, then you also perform this activity. Otherwise, you need to perform this one activity. I hope students, you understand this activity both. Thank you and have a nice day. Stay home, stay safe.